Hello students, today our topic is MySQL, and in this lecture we are going to discuss some aggregate function. We already discussed some function, count function, and in this lecture our main focus is to discuss about average function. So we will see how average functions work in MySQL in this lecture. So our main focus is about aggregate function. These are all basically are all our aggregate functions. So we will discuss aggregate function in this lecture. Let's start.
Good morning students, today our topic is MySQL aggregate function, and as you know that this is a MySQL revision part 3 regarding to aggregate functions. In our previous lecture we already discussed count function and sum function, and in this lecture we will going to discuss another aggregate function, AVG function, that means average function. So first of all, let's start with the definition of aggregate function. Aggregate function is a function where the values of multiple rows are grouped together to form a single summary value. That's why they are called the aggregate, because they aggregate or makes a sum or give you a summary value. So count function is used to count different number of rows, sum function to add different number of values, and average to calculate average of different number of values. So let's start MySQL average function. The MySQL average is an aggregate function used to return the average value of an expression in various records. So there are different expressions present in various records, and average function is used to find out the average of that values. And syntax is very simple. It is always used with select statement. So just write select, after that AVG, name of the average function here, and the aggregate expression where you want to find out the average value, and then from, and then after table's name, it may be a single table or it may be a different table. So aggregate functions may belongs to different tables, or most of the time it belongs to a single table. And conditions, at last condition. It is optional. If the condition is met, then according to that aggregate, according to that average will be count. And if there is no condition at all, then it count all the values given in aggregate expressions. So this is all about average function. Syntax is very simple. To calculate average, you just use AVG. AVG always. Don't write full name. Just write AVG to calculate average, and that is the representation of a function. Sign of parenthesis. And within that parenthesis sign, always give a value which you want to perform on that. Such as aggregate expression here. For example, if I want to calculate average of average of 1, 2, 3, then you just write AVG and just write 1, 2, 3. Now here is again a question that 1, 2, 3 belongs to which table? If we want to just calculate a simple calculation using average function, is it possible? Answer yes, this is possible. And we always know that we use select statement with average function. So just write select and AVG 1, 2, 3. And what is the name of the table? Then always remember that just write from. And if you want to calculate simple calculation, then there is a table named dual. It is a system generated table, dummy table here. So you can write and then after semicolon sign, so you can easily find the average of different values. It may be two values, three values, they may be number or they may be float value. You can easily count the average of different values. And if there is a table, then there is no problem at all. Just write that syntax that is given here. Now I think it is clear to all of you. So most important point is use AVG function to calculate average of different values. And these different values may be numbers or it may be float values. Remember that for this type of calculation use a dummy table named DUAL. DUAL. It is a system generated table or MySQL default table. But when there is a table given, then you can use average function using that table. So just write select after that ABG expression, average expression, then after from table. And if there is a condition, then just write where condition and always mark condition with where clause. And at last, there is a sign of colon. You can see here that where in syntax where condition is written in square bracket. And why it is so? It represents basically optional parameter. It means it is not a compulsory part that you always use a where condition. It is according to the requirement. So optional part are always given within a syntax in square bracket. So this is another important part here. Now parameter explained here. Aggregate expression, it specifies the columns or the expressions. Columns or the expression that we are going to find the average result. And table name, it specifies the table from where we want to retrieve records. There must be at least one table listed in the from clause. As I told you that there must be at least one table. You can calculate average of different values which are belongs to different column, which are belongs to different tables. And at last, where condition. So it is optional, as I told you. It specifies the conditions that must be fulfilled for the records to be selected. Now this is a table, this is an example. And let us suppose this table is already created. And if you want to create this table, for this purpose you can first of all use create table command. And if you want to insert the data into this table, just use insert into command. So using these two commands you can create a table and insert the data into the table. Now the table name here is employees. You can see there here we just try to command select staff from employees. It means all the records belongs to the table employee will be appear here. And there are five columns name, or we can say that attributes: employee ID, employee name, occupation, working date and working hours. And for these five columns there are different records, 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 records are there. And there is a duplication of record also, you can easily see here. Just in case that Joseph business dated 22 4 10 here, and Joseph is also appear here, but with different working date of same working hours. So in the case of Peter, it is also same. Peter is a teacher, and there is a repetition of data again, but the only difference is in terms of working date. So working date is different, name of the employees and occupation and working hours is same. You can easily see there here. And this is for other data also. This is same for Mark. Employee name is Mark also. Joseph, there is a Peter. Peter is also there. Peter is a teacher, you can see here. And working days is different for Peter. 14 and 10 working hours are working hours of Peter are 9 hours. The same. So here we can easily see that this is a table which have 5 column name, and name of the table is employee. Employee ID, employee name, occupation, working date, and working hours. There are certain number of employees, and they have some occupation. They may be a businessman, doctor, engineer, or teacher, and their working date is different, but working hour is same for one person. So this is the data of regarding to the table employee. Now let us check it. Basic example to calculate average. Select ABG working hours, average working hours from employees. You can see here that select command is used, and with that select command average function is used, and within the parenthesis name of the column is given here, and name of the column is working hours. It means this working hours is given here, and after that name is given. Actually this is a name, alternative name of this column ABJ working hours, and there are three different types of representations of the alternative name. We can use it as using as keyword, or we can just write it as it is within double quotes. So what happens, it actually makes the name of the column in that table, and the table name is from employee, of course. So it will, after the execution of this command in MySQL, it will take the average of these working hours. First of all, just take its sum, and after that it divided by number of persons, and number of persons I think that is 10, because 10 records are there. So divided by 10, and it is 11.100. This is the average. So this is the basic example of average function. Next, what happens if there is a condition? You can see here the condition given as working hour is greater than equal to 12. So average will be count for only for that working hours where working hours are greater than equal to 10. It means this is our actual table. So first is not selected, second is selected, third is also selected, fourth is 9 is not selected, 10 is not selected, 15 is selected, 9 is not selected, 12 is selected, 10 is not selected, 9 is not selected. So only 4, 1, 2, 3, and then 4. 4 values are selected, and average of these 4 values are here, because in condition there is already mentioned working hours greater than equal to 12. So average is 13.5. You can see. So if you put a condition, so according to that condition average will be count according to that condition. Now as MySQL average function with group by clause. As you know that when we use group by clause, it basically makes a group on the basis of certain columns here. So and Second important thing is that group by clause most of the time used with the aggregate functions. Aggregate function are most of the time used with group by clause. It is a correct statement. So here you can easily see that first of all we make a group on the basis of occupation. So first of all, when we make a group on the basis of some occupation, then just see the actual table. These are the occupation. And first of all, just write occupation only a single time if it appear more than one time. So these are business, doctors, engineer, and teacher. These are the four occupations. And there is a formation of group on the basis of occupation. So there are five. There are actually four occupation here. And you can see here. So this will be appear here. And next, here take a average of working hours, and that average of working hours will be reflected with occupation. On the behalf of that we make a group, and some other column name will also appear here that are given with select statement, and this is employee name. But our main concern is condition on behalf of that group is formed, and average, and the aggregate function passed within the parenthesis of average function. So here you can easily see that. So on the basis of occupation, make certain groups and then calculate average of that occupation. It means business appear if two times here, two or three times. Suppose business appear here 1, 2, and 3 times, then 10, and then 10, and then 10. So total is 30, I think, if I am not wrong. Then this average is reflected here. And second important thing is that when we take an average, then answer will be always in a float value. That is occupation, that is average working hour, and that is employee name, because employee name are all given here with select clause. With select statement. So let us consider it in single command. Select, first of all, it select all the data, all the columns name. The columns names are employee name. So employee name will be selected, occupation, and occupation will be also be selected, and the average, and the average of working hours will be calculated. And there is an alternative name of working hour, average working hours, and that name is average working hour, that represented here. And then from keyword, and then name of the table is employee, and the group by is, then we use a keyword group by, and we make a group on the basis of occupation is the name of column. So group is formed on the basis of occupation, and there are four different occupations. And average of these average regarding to the working hour, average regarding to this occupation is to be calculated here. You can see here. So this is the description of average function with group by clause. Always remember that in group by clause we make always a group, and with group by clause aggregate functions are always used with group by clause, and whatever be the condition given within the average, that will works with the column name given after group by, that is occupation. So here average is calculated according the group by occupation here. So first of all, different occupations are counted here, and according to that average working hour of that occupation will be calculated. And that you can see on a screen that this is the answer. Next is having clause. Having clause, as you know that whenever there is a condition related to a group by clause, that condition must be given with having clause. So here all the things are same as that of the previous one, which I already discussed here. But here is a condition, and condition is on group, and the condition is that working hour must be greater than 9. So their working hours, you can see this is the output. Okay, working hour must be greater than 9. Having average working hours must be greater than 9. In previous case, you can see here that the average of teacher working hours is 9 here. And when we mention in a condition that having average working hours greater than 9, then that last record or row will not appear in your answer. And that is the answer. So the use of having clause is to give a condition related to group by clause. And you can see here that with having clause they should always be given a aggregate function, because group by clause works with a aggregate function. So when we give a condition related to a group by clause, so condition must be given with having clause. And that condition actually holds an aggregate function, and aggregate function is average. So here are already written as having AVJ working hours greater than or equal to 9. Now if there is a general condition and that condition is not depend on a group by clause, then we put that condition here. Then condition here. But if there are a condition related to a group by clause, then this should be marked after, just after that of the having clause. So these are the two or three important points. I hope that is clear to all of you. Just see that. This part is same when we discuss about group by clause compared to group by clause, but only the difference between these two is that having condition. And always remember that having clause is always given with group by clause when there is a condition imposed on a group, first thing. Second thing, having condition always mark the condition in the terms of aggregate function, and the here aggregate function is average. So we just write average working hours greater than or equal to 9. And if there is a general condition, so this condition is related to given after from clause or from table name. So condition related to group is always marked with having clause, and having clause is given just after that of the group by clause. This is a very important point. And to make a question much more difficult, it may be possible that there is a general condition given here and that condition not belongs to that group, and this condition should be marked just after that of the from clause and here. And after that, if there is a condition imposed on a group, then this condition must be given with having clause just after the occupy clause. Next, our next is, you can see this is the output. Here you can easily notice that working hours are 9, so all the working hours are greater than 9. In our previous example, where there is no having clause, so Peter teacher 9.0 is appear here, but when we impose the condition and apply that having average working hours greater than 9, then this is removed in the your final answer. Now our next function, our next or last topic regarding to that average distinct clause. As you know that distinct clause basically removes the duplicate rows and consider it as a one unit. So whenever there is a duplication and we want to remove it, then it is possible using distinct clause. Now let us see here. Just write select employee name, occupation, these are the name of the columns, average distinct working hours. Distinct working hours means if there is a repetitions of working hour, these are the same value of working hours, then it is considered as a one unit. And average working hours is the name of the column, and then from employees, the name of the table, and group by on the basis of occupation. So first of all, let us see the original table. This is the original table, and you can see that working hour is repeated more than one times. 10 appears here, here, and here, and in this similar manner, this is a repetition of value 15 also. 15 appears 2 times. 9 is also there. 9 is appeared 3 times here. 12 also appear 2 times here. And 10 also appear 1, 2, 3 times here. So when we use distinct clause, it means the value which are repeated more than one times are considered as a 1, and only that average will be counted. And then you can see that on the basis of occupation, and the final answer looks like this: 10, 15, 12, and 9, because these are the single values. And when you take a value of a average of 10, then it of course just average of 10 is of course a 10, because there is a single value, and average of single value is the value itself. Similarly, value of average of 15 is of 15 itself, and 12 is 12 itself. So these are the different values, average values appear here, because you take here average of distinct working hours, and group by is found on the basis of occupation. So different occupations are appear here: business, doctor, engineer, teacher. And here we have to calculate average working hours, or MySQL calculate, just calculate average working hours. But since this is a distinct clause here, because of the distinct clause, the repeated values are not considered, or considered as a single unit, or considered only one time here. So that's why they are appear here: 10, 15, 12, and 9. So this is a use of distinct clause. Now I hope this concept is clear to all of you. So first of all, remember two or more important things. Different aggregate functions are used with group by clause, and there is always a probability that group by clause is asked with the aggregate function in your examination, whether it is a form of output based question or a query may be asked, and it may be asked separately, the use of different aggregate functions, because they are specifically marked in your new syllabus of session 2020 and 21. So practice all the type of different questions, and just memorize the concept of different functions, the use of different functions, and implement it with group by clause, group by with having clause, distinct clause. And just in simple, just as I told you and earlier, that if you want to calculate the average of different values and that is not a part of any table, then just try to select and then put the name of the that column name, and after that a dummy table name dual must be there if there is no table name, because select statement is always used with the table name. So these are some important points. I hope you like this video. Thanks for watching this video.